Welcome to worship. My name is Reva, and we're excited to have you here for worship this evening, or this morning, sorry. Okay, so today we hear the story of the resurrection of Christ, the story where God builds a bridge between us and eternal life, the story where the barrier of sin was broken. Let today be a reminder of what that means to you. Christ is risen. Let us stand and greet each other with signs of peace and love.
Sing together, Up From the Grave He Arose.
So I'm going to invite you all to stand and sing a song with me. This song is called O Glorious Day by Casting Crowns. And I'll play the chorus for you really quick so you know how it goes.
Living, He loved me. Dying, He saved me. Buried, He carried my sins far away. rising he justified freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day. One day when heaven was filled with his praises, one day when sin was as black as could be, Jesus came forth to be born of a virgin, dwelt among men, my example is he. Word became flesh and the light shined among us, glory revealed, sing this with me, living he loved me, dying he saved me, Mary he carried my sins far away, rising he justified freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day. One day they led him up Calvary's mountain, one day they nailed him to die on a tree, suffering anguish, despised and rejected, bearing our sins, my Redeemer is he. Hands that held nations stretched out a tree and took the nails for me, living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away, rising he justified freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day. One day the grave could conceal him no longer. One day the stone rolled away from the door. Then he arose over death he had conquered. Now he's ascended, my Lord, evermore. Death could not hold him, the grave could not keep him. Rising again, living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away, rising he justified freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day. Let's sing that one more time. Living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away, rising he justified freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day, oh glorious day.
Good morning. I have a little reading to do, so. Jesus died for our sins. All sins have a penalty. We see the same thing in the justice system of our nation. For every crime, there's a penalty. When the penalty is paid, we say justice has been served. The penalty of sinning is not just physical, but spiritual as well. In physical death, our bodies are separated from our souls and spirit. In spiritual death, we are separated from God. Jesus died for our sins. He paid the penalty for our crime. This does not mean that we stop sinning. What it does mean is that the penalty incurred by our sin has been paid by an individual who did nothing wrong, so that we may be together with God for all eternity. Many of us have done good, but nobody except Jesus has died for the sins of another. Throughout our service today, we encourage you to remember that you are forgiven. The sacrifice and resurrection of your Savior Jesus Christ has restored you. He made you new, just like the flowers of spring, a time of rejuvenation.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, I humbly come before you to thank you. Thank you for giving us a Savior who died on the cross for our sins. Your crucifixion meant you were willing to give up your life far for our sins. You were innocent, pure, and you took it upon yourself to carry our shame on the cross. Your resurrection was so powerful in that you showed us your everlasting glory. When you were taken up into heaven, you gave us a lasting promise of your return. I know one day we will be with you, and I thank you for what you have done in this season, but I also hope we will take the time to remember and thank you for everything else that you have done for us. In this I pray. Amen.
Okay, I'm going to invite you all to stand again. I'm going to sing another song and worship him. This song is called Song of Hope. I'll sing the chorus for you again, and feel free to join in.
I will sing a song of hope, sing along. God of heaven, come down, heaven, come down. Just to know that you are near is enough. God of heaven, come down, heaven, come down.
Yeah.
have you come down? Just to know that you are near is enough. God, if have you come down, have you come down? I will sing a song for, sing along. God,
at this time, I invite our youth to take our positions for our victory over death, our sharing of the story.
As evening approached, there came a rich man from Arimathea named Joseph, who had himself become a disciple of Jesus. Going to Pilate, he asked for Jesus' body. Pilate ordered that it be given to Joseph. Joseph took the body and wrapped it in a clean linen cloth. Jesus' body was then placed in his own new tomb that Joseph had cut out of rock. Joseph rolled a big stone in front of the entrance to the tomb and went away.
The next day, the one after preparation day, the chief priests and the Pharisees went to Pilate. "Sir," they said, "we remember that while he was still alive, the deceiver said, 'After 3 days I will rise again.' So give the order for the tomb to be made secure until the third day. Otherwise, his disciples may come and steal the body and tell the people that he has been raised from the dead." Pilate answered, "Go make the tomb secure by putting a seal on the stone and posting a guard."
Matthew 28:2-4. There was a violent earthquake. For an angel of the Lord came down from heaven and, going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men.
Matthew 28:5-8. The angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here. He is risen. Go quickly and tell his disciples. He has risen from the dead and is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him. Now I have told you. So the women hurried away from the tomb, afraid, yet filled with joy, and ran to tell his disciples.
Then the disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus had told them to go. When they saw Jesus, they worshipped him, but some doubted. Then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I'm with you always, to the very end of the age."
Jesus was with them 40 more days before he ascended. After the Lord Jesus had spoken to the disciples, he was taken up into heaven, and he sat at the right hand of God. Then the disciples went out and preached everywhere, and the Lord worked with them and confirmed his word by the signs that accompanied it.
John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life." Would you please stand and join us in the Apostles' Creed?
Buried. The third victory. Death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. Empty cross and empty grave. Life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive.
On the cross is a reminder that you are new. Jesus has risen. He has washed away your sins. Go in peace, rejuvenated and new. This is a day of celebration. Go and be happy.
happiness.